I shall draw its focus.
Thank you.
work done gracelessly is worth.
Beg pardon if my hospitality is a bit lacking, sir. My adieu, but if you seek a bed and you've the coin, tis yours. No questions asked. glad to be of service, sir.
Well chosen, Arisen. I'm certain you'll...
Beg pardon if my hospitality... But if you seek a bed and you've the coin, it's yours. No questions asked. Glad to be of service, sir.
Work done graciously. Work done poorly.
Beg pardon if my hospitality... But if you seek a bed and you've the coin, it's your...
Glad to be of service, sir.
Beg pardon if... But if you seek a bed and you've the coin, it's yours. No questions asked.
We must rest. Though... I feel refreshed and ready for a new day. Come, we've much to be getting on with.
Feeling rested, I trust.
I happen to understand Elvish, Master. I expect you'll find my talents useful. Should we encamp? Tis a pity we must part after sharing such a journey. Are you fit to travel? Then let's... A troubling rumor has reached my ears, and methinks I ought to share it. Tis said there is an illness pawns can contract beyond the rift that inflicts unspeakable harm on those around them. As it progresses, the pawn gradually loses all self-control, and in time will even cease to heed the Arisen's commands.
Indeed. Well, we shall have to remain watchful, lest one of our company should start showing signs of this sickness.
What purpose does this contraption serve? Perhaps you might investigate, Arisen. We pawns will be ready to respond, whatever the outcome. It is hard to find my footing in this darkness.
Well now, I'm a lucky man. Thought I was waiting here for naught. But when someone finally does come along, 'tis you. I've always wanted a real fight with you, one on one. Here's my chance.
Holding back on me, are you, Sir Arisen?
To Sir Ragnar, Master. You have heard a whisper of the man's disembodied ways in the cave, yet there he stands.
You seem to desire a bout. You ought to fight him alone.
Twas I.
You have bested Sir Ragnar, Master, an incomparable feat. But we cannot revel in your triumph. We must press on.
Indeed, you are correct.
You got me.
dragon. Heed my call. Your will is mine to command. Curses. This arrival of the true risen is most inopportune. Sovereign of Vermin, the ritual must not be disturbed. Let not the arisen approach. You can manage that, I trust.
It is of vital import that we have a word with Lord Basil. The pendant must not be perfect.
Efforts are for naught to reason. Now, simply watch as this world's hollow and fruitless order is remade by my hand. The ritual is complete. The dragon comes. Behold! The Royce Dragon! By my power, the dogma of dragons is unmade. You could ne'er understand, Arisen. We must all be freed from the vulgar order wherein the dragon's existence determines all.
Arisen, hast thou summoned the resolution to face me? Then answer me this. Why dost thou fight? Is it to reclaim thy flesh, thy stolen heart? Or is it to reclaim thy throne? I offer thee a choice. Grant unto me this life in my claws, and be gone from this place. Or stand and fight. Pitiable Arisen. The time for thou to make thy choice is come. Show me the path thou wouldst walk. Go, and thou shalt live to claim thy coveted throne. abides and thy life is forfeit. Thou wilt face the dragon's dogma. The decision is that thou wouldst flee. This is the path thou hast chosen, Arisen. Thy choice is made. Return to thy kingdom. The world thou desired awaiteth thee there. A hollow world, if a restful one.
It's of vital importance that we have a word with Lord Vader.
Let my magic imbue your weapon with the fury of the elements.
And thy life is forfeit. Thou wilt face the dragon's dogma. The decision is thine to make. Wilt thou prove thy subservience and face me, or wilt thou instead seek glorious escape?
Stay away.
Pray. Turn back.
Leave now, while you can.
You have strayed, Arisen. And for what? Lest you forget. You have a world where you belong. There, you are to fell the great evil in your path and rule the people as their sovereign. For that is who you are. And it is my wish that you should live out that life of purpose. The time has come for you to return. Go. My children shall see you there safely.
Let us go home, together.
To a world under your rightful rule.
To a world all your own.
This is your will? Then behold, a world unmerciful, left with the benevolent hands of gods. Strange. But this is your world, the world to which you longed to return. Alas, if only you had chosen to become sovereign. At the end of your travails, you could have ruled over these lands in perpetual peace. Yet that world of limitless possibilities has ended. You stand now. Upon its remains, the vestiges of a world that could have been so much more. Innumerable wills have served to deliver this world from extinction time and time again. You alone have refused to carry out that great purpose. What you see before you is the consequence of your apathy. Behold. As it has failed to be chosen, and as 'twill ne'er be read, this world will soon cease to exist. In the blink of an eye, the sickle of oblivion will reap aught that you have known. I would advise you not to waste these last moments. Explore the remnants of this world while you can. Perhaps, in doing so, you shall come to see the truth. And know the wretchedness of a world unworthy of being chronicled. How shall you fare, I wonder? Will you endure in this world, abandoned and unprotected?
By your commander, is it?
We seem to have arrived without issue, but are we safe here?
Marion Dulder, I'm a life and apprentice. With Brocker's teachings under my belt, there's nothing I can't handle. So ask away. My hammer is at your disposal, sir. pleasure doing business with you.
To overthink it, you can change. It on a whim. You've many thanks.
Our strategy for safeguard. Running the Arisen.
Poi! No need to overthink it. You can change it on a whim. You've naught to lose, and you might even make a new displeasure doing business.
Most of only do take care to leave the room as you found it. If there's one thing I shan't suffer, 'tis untidy lodgers. Do come again.
This might be worth a read.
Shall we take a closer look?
The road ahead is Longmaster. What are fairy stones for if not times such as these?
You have my support. first.
This ought to be protected.
What has become of the world? Would that there was someone who could explain this madness.
Come to think of it, did not Sir Atheus speak of releasing the world from its bonds in the Seafloor Shrine?
If this is indeed the World Unbound, then perhaps we ought to seek out his wisdom. You're the Arisen,
aye?
I am to inform you that Lord Phasis requests your presence at the Forbidden Magic Research Lab. As to whether you heed him, I care not.